Hey guys, Vali here, and welcome back to Zero AD. And right now, I am playing a 4v4 match. I am playing as the Ptolemies. Okay, I am in the pocket, which is nice because I did intend to go for a boomy approach here. Then focus on the economy, then go from there, you know. Like, I think I'll go like pretty much full economy focus for a while. And then try to do champion Pikemen, because I think those units are quite insane, honestly. Especially with the Ptolemy hero bonus. Like, this guy here for 40% extra hit points on Pikemen. It's, I think, a pretty insane unit in combination with that bonus. Especially, like, so I want to see how well that will go for me, yeah? How strong it will be, all that good stuff. So let's get the barrack being built already. We've got extra berries, we've got deer right there. So yeah, just play really, really greedy. She will keep on building houses for eternity, pretty much. We'll need to add a few more builders later on, though, that's for sure. On my team we have Maurians, Britons, Persians. No great team bonus, sadly. Yeah, then they've got Ptolemies. What else did they have? Carthaginians, Persians, and Carthaginians. Alright. I hope their Ptolemies are on the other side there, because I want to see like how the archer seals will hold up against the pikemen. That's the biggest thing I want to see here. Because I have a slight suspicion I'll just be able to walk over them without any trouble. Like, I did this in a 1v1 game a while back and it just completely destroyed, so. And that was against like skirmishers and such units which have, you know, more damage output, so I really want to see how this will go against like archers. That's my big of thing to check here. Was I pocket to whom? Pocket to Zodin to Orange. See, I might be a bit of trouble like there if I do need to help him out a bit. But we'll see. Yeah. Can't do so many right away. Bring them over to berries. Let's get the woodcutting upgrade. Yeah, send them right over to stone, I guess. Yeah, use the building snap feature. Yeah, they will go to wood now. Okay, that's Berhudar, the Persians. Nice, nice, nice. So we want them going straight over to fields then. And who is the pocket? Weird jokes. Alright. Alright, I can deal with that. I can deal with that. Weird jokes pocket for us. That's friendly. Oh no, that's not friendly. What's that? Ah, that is friendly. That is friendly. It's all good. So yeah, just simply add more woodcutters, add more farms, just keep going like this the whole time, basically. That's all we do here, that is all we do. And camel rushing, isn't great against archer civilizations, can still harass food and so on very well, but I want to just boom and try to go for the champions here. Come on. Come on, what was that? What was that? Who else did we have on our team? Persians and Britons. Alright. Wait, what was the Briton bonus actually? I don't even really remember. What was the Briton bonus like? I don't really remember that. Oh, why do you hunt like this, my guy? What was that? What was that? What was that? Farming, forgot to get that upgrade? Kinda suboptimal, eh? Kinda suboptimal. Should have gone a storehouse build here too. A little bit rusty there, you know, on the macro. A little bit rusty. Go right over there. Go right over there. So we will be adding in a second barrack very, very soon here. Like in this release of Zero AD, if you you've just got to add 3 barracks, there's no other way to go about it. Want to boom, want to go aggressive, you need 3 barracks. No way around that. But maybe in team games you can get away with 2, I suppose, but still. Give me that stone. Give me that stone, gosh darn it. Let's force drop some stone to make sure we get what we need. Oh, we're still short. Oh, you've got to be kidding me. You've got to be kidding me, man. Okay, now forge drop the stone. That's a lot of idle time we just got there. That's a pretty big mistake to bring them out so early then. Ay, ay, ay. Ay, 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 ay. You've got places to work. Come on, there are... Oh, no, there are only... There are... That area, there are only 4 fields. Okay, that's fine then. That's fine. Yeah, the Ptolemies, you really do want to just keep adding new storehouses non-stop almost. As soon as you can squeeze one in, you add it. Yeah, just keep adding. Actually, I think I do need more fields. I do need more fields here. Ah, again, Camel Rush. Darn it, man. I wasn't expecting me to be hit, really. I wasn't expecting myself to get hit, you know. I was hoping I wouldn't. So what you need to do is just get all the way up here. Then hope he doesn't come around from the other side. This we've got like all walled up, so that should make things a little bit more awkward for him. Which is great. Am I not raining? So oh, not raining here, what? Nope, that's not happening. Ay, 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 ay. If I want to counter him at the moment, I have got to use the towers and hope he doesn't go around. Like, this wall here is honestly really good for me. Or I've got to make my own camels. In a 1v1, like, I would have to be making camels here in a team game. I can just hope he will go to, like, my teammates and harass them instead. Weird jokes with camels to you. Who is purple? Okay. Pro communication out here. Ah, unless he goes to harass me from the other side. The bastard, man, the bastard. Yeah, then I need to build a tower there. Like, as I said, against archer civilizations, this is quite useless against, like, the simple... But Gauls, Britons, seals which don't have spear, cavalry, or archers, this is basically a free win. And in a Ptolemy mirror, you must do your own camel archers to counter here. I mean, it's better than in other matchups, like right where you just simply lost the game is your Gauls or Britons and you get Camel Rush, so it's not that bad, but still. Can still manage to complain about it, you know, that's for sure. Give me the wood! Give me the wood, gosh darn it, man! Give me the wood! Give me the wood, you bastards! Hey, let's get this built. I already placed the foundation, I didn't realize that. Thought I hadn't. Let's get loon so our women don't die as easily. Yeah, he'll focus us, won't he, I guess. That's still fine, at least he's not hitting our teammates, I suppose, in that case, yeah? Is he in range? Doesn't seem like he's... At least he's in range of that tower, that's good still, that's good. But yeah, the Ptolemies are an insane civilization, man. Like, they get a free win against half the Zeus by using camel archers. And against the archer civilizations or the spear cavalry civilizations. They just win it pikemen. Against the spear cow Zeus, they have much better eco, they can really do whatever. Against archer Zeus, if you do pikemen, you've also got a free win. Like, they're such an insane civilization at the moment. Like, how they position this? That should be fine. By free win, I mean, you know, like, obviously you can still get outplayed, but if you don't make any big mistakes, you should be really well off. How many woodcutters? 45 in a little bit. Let's do one more set of soldiers, then we can start thinking about clicking up, yeah. And we should be well off for that. Oh, yeah, you're going around like this, boys. Okay, he will go there, he will stop trying to harass me, that's good. That's all we need out here, you know, that's all we need. Now this area is kind of walled off. Oh, does that... No way that cliff goes to the edge of the map for me, no way. There's no way that happens. Yeah, I've got some lag here. Got some lag. So yeah, we'll have to wait for him to rejoin then. And we are going again. So yeah, one thing I realized, you know, like... whilst waiting here is that we don't really see any extra metal mines, which is a slight issue. A slight problem. I got just one slinger, all I need. He will run around the back of the base and hopefully find some metal mines around here. Like in the middle of the map, we don't see any. And yeah, team games generally not played on the balanced maps mod, which would ensure everyone has the exact same amount of extra food, resources, all that stuff. So I suppose like a lot of people can't really be bothered to get it or something. Not sure, but that's how it is. We've got the market. Let's build the market actually a little bit towards the back. Yeah, a little bit more towards the back. Get over here just simply. Alright. Can't really do that. Yeah, just get a temple, I suppose, and build the market right here in the back. That's fine. Yo, boys, help out with the blacksmith a little bit. Help out with that a little bit, eh? Will we find any metal mines? Otherwise, you'll just simply go for like a pretty huge wood economy today and get some traders set up to give us consistent metal income, yeah? Ah, missed out on those berries there. Nothing in the back there. Maybe something right there. You'll have to scout that out too. I'll just check that area, yeah, make sure. Otherwise, it looks like I will be... there's a metal mine there. But that's also really close to an enemy. And to a different enemy who I don't really mean to be fighting with, yeah? So... I think we will just simply set up a military colony right here. I mean, the sooner I do that, the better, right? That way I can at least ensure I will get it built. Let's not send so many women forward, though. And yeah, like, gang... a forward position here will be really nice too. So you can set up the barracks because the pikemen do move very, very slowly. So that will be very important as well. Getting that all set up. Turn off shadows. And I guess, yeah, let's actually go and get some traders going. Does he have anything there? Nah, he doesn't. That's only 10 gain though. That's not really... great. I guess we can trade between ourselves and orange. Not orange, but like purple and orange there. Yeah, that should be fine too. That should be fine too. Buy some metal. Get the wood cutting upgrade. Which one did I click? That's the wrong one. Not the one I want. So if you want. Probably should not have bartered away my food. Not really. So we'll want to get this, this research done. Now, do we get like a forward fort there? Don't think I will. Maybe we want to bring a lot of these women over to food now so they can afford to really spam the champions. Knowing programming and that doesn't have any correlation. If I will know when A25 will be released. I mean, they've said they want to release it, like, what, in, like... the normal cycle should be, like, what, half a year to a year, but you never know, man. You can never be too sure. Maybe... 6 months to a year was the hope. Yeah, let's get this dude trained up, too. Obviously, no way to know, man. A hope isn't the reality. Oh, what I need to do here is 100% on the metal. And this market, yes, that's what we need. I can't add Zeus. I can't add Zeus, mate.
Yes,
can't do that, you know. Cannot do that. So we'll need to start getting... How long do I get that? 15 seconds. Yeah, we'll need to start getting military upgrades too. We should have quite a few farmers ready to go as well. Maybe should have done a... Oh, come on. Yeah, that's annoying that they just simply target our serve goal, set them to stand ground. And yeah, this will... I'll be getting ranged, yeah. No alarm, no anything to let me know, which is really annoying. Let's start getting the pikemen all trained up. Very nice. Get pierce armor upgrades, that's all we really need here. Health, that's useless. As long as we don't get raided, that is useless. Oh, you are stuck, aren't you? No, you're fine. You are fine. Maybe they don't really need to upgrade the towers there, but whatever. Whatever. I will need siege, though. My teammate just can't really provide me any siege weapons, can he? Yeah, he's nowhere near phase 3. I don't really want to be making an elephant stable here, but... I suppose, unfortunately, I will have to. Yes, I can have some siege weapons out. Elephants aren't really siege weapons, but they feel their role very, very well. I mean, rams might have been actually a bit bare, but whatever. Yeah, go to wood for now, go to wood. Oh, I forgot to get the library built again. I completely forget about that thing existing at the moment. Quite too frequently, you know, whatever. Well, if I've gone so long without it, I guess I'll go to the end without it, yeah? Get some slingers out in support, as support units. Get some elephants, and then you have the elephants, you can go and push. Just need to get the second pierce resistance upgrade, and then we are completely set. Oh, you guys can't work, I forgot about that. You dudes cannot work. Ah, that's a bit annoying. That is a bit annoying. Harder away some stone for... not really worth too much, I can still buy some... wood for it though, which I'll do, so I can afford the last wood cutting upgrade. Oh, he's in phase 3, okay, nice, nice, nice. So we'll have some siege support, which is great. Not something I can complain about, right? Something very positive. Let's see what, like, blue has to come in support with. Yeah, you dudes got nothing to do, you dudes don't really don't have anything to do either. I need to get that metal mine back in a little bit, you know, quite soon. Because otherwise I'm just gonna be all empty on metal, don't have any. They've all already kinda ruined the prices, the bastards, man. Why do they need stuff too? Why do they need to afford stuff too, huh? The bastards. Let's get one more elephant out, then we should be ready to attack. You attack Zodin. Yeah, I should have done like a few more soldiers here in the early part of the match, yeah, so I could afford all this stuff a bit more quickly. Would have been a bit bare by me, but oh well. This temple and like that stuff will all be blocking me a lot here. Huh? That will all be blocking me a lot. Let's keep the hero in the back, don't keep the hero in the back, let's keep getting some more champions out to the front. Yeah, kinda wish I actually did a few more traders at the moment, don't I? Wish I did a few more of them. They're just all getting stuck, man, that's so annoying! I've got the elephant going forward alone! Need to just transfer them through, yeah, they're all, yeah, the hero isn't supporting my pikemen here, which is the worst part. They're just there all alone, not being supported. That's terrible. Can't afford the metal. Yeah, it was a bad decision to...
EST?
Then go for champions if I don't really have any metal mines extra. Yeah, he will just completely fall apart. Look at the champions, they aren't even getting hurt. They are not even getting hurt, man. Insane unit. Insane, I told you, man, this would be unstoppable for him, man, I told you. Hey, fight, boys, fight. Capture the barracks, take the barracks. Oh, he's focusing down the elephant. This will work out perfectly. Ah, almost perfectly, just destroy the tower. Yourselves, finish the job yourselves, eh? Finish the job yourselves. Let's get the trade guy and upgrade force, let's get that forced. He's just unable to do anything here, man. He's unable to do anything. Okay, capture this. Can repair it, boys. Now, these units are insane, aren't they, yeah? I mean, he had support from Orange, too. Do I have the hero right there? Yes, I do. So they have 280 hit points, 80 hit points, and they have 80% damage resistance. Nah, insane units. Again, lacking metal quite a lot. Let's get some more barracks built. That's kind of something I'm skipping out on a bit. Cheap out on the barracks, yeah, not a good thing to do at all. So yeah, you boys go to metal right here in the front. Anyone got too much metal? I could beg Orange for metal, I suppose. Does he have any mines? No, he doesn't, so he will need it for himself too. Oh, goodness my, yeah. I've got to insist to play like the next matches with the balanced maps mode, man, because otherwise this is just disaster. Otherwise it's just all disaster, man, because it's so unfair as to who gets metal and who doesn't. Gives such a big advantage to some players, and while some have to buy it or just set up trade and wait a while until they get anything really rolling. Okay. Yeah, we're in the trade, like in the woodline too now. That's good. Go on, stone. I think stone cost actually would be quite decent too, quite likely. Yeah, stone is worth quite a bit now. It's worth quite a bit. Oh, the hero is getting hit. The bastards are attacking my hero at the moment, huh? Yeah, Bearhood are having connection issues, so I hate the passive stance, man. That's such a flawed concept, I feel like. Because these units will run around the whole map chasing this one priester and they will never catch up. Like, either switch to a different unit or whatever. Just don't keep chasing that same dude forever, man. Don't keep chasing the same dude forever. Now this fight will literally never end here, will it? Oh, we've got light blue helping too. Put them in the camp, put them in the entrenched army camp, yeah. Oh, how is red doing? Yeah, red is falling apart like he has no support. He had black fighting and then purple coming in afterwards, and yeah, red can't fight against two. He can't deal against with two players. Let's go deal with this, man. And I need the miners there. I do need the miners. I've got to send a few more over to wood here too. Go to wood, boys. Go to wood. Let's do it like this. Oh god, the elephant! That's... No, the hero! My hero, man. My hero. That was my big thing. Oh, come on. Come on. Again, this is why we don't really see, you know, those heroes used too much. You just see, like, guys like this. Whom you can hide in a corner and never put in any danger. And it makes sense, either if you can lose your hero. And that's what we see a lot too, is just set the hero to passive stance that way. It's two benefits, a hero won't die and you can also have the whole enemy army go really out of position chasing the hero like my two champion pikemen did there chasing that one priest. Like, it screws over the enemy and it helps you, like, it's great. It's, I feel like, just passive stances are such a flat concept, I think. Yeah, I got spectators joining, like, from that. Need some more traders, dude. Need some more traders, need some more trade income. The Civic Center, ah yeah, the Civic Center being repaired there.
DSD?
Look! Oh, the elephant, you've got to be kidding me, man. Destroyed, killed the elephant.
DSD? Crasso. Crasso. DSD?
Like, you should be able to push that through. Kill the elephant, man. Gosh darn it, I need to get like the attack upgrade too. The second to last attack. Yeah, the last attack upgrade, what am I saying? Will the elephant actually die before killing my... Okay, yeah. It won't be able to destroy my... entrenched army camp. Wait, not entrenched army camp, the military colony. What am I saying? What am I saying? More traders. And just more of these dudes. Yeah, the game does drag on, which I don't think it will. Like, I need to use the really strong trade I've got set. Actually, what am I doing? Just go well to metal, boys. Go well to metal there. Okay, take the tower. Beautiful, and just take houses now. Take houses.
DST? DST?
Keep one garrison. I think only one needs to be garrisoned there, yeah? And just capture houses so he gets popcapped and can't really support the fight anymore, you know? Yeah, cut off the reinforcing units so they can't get to the fight. That's all we need to be doing here, really. Anyone need wood? Like, all of them need wood. Let's get the farming upgrade too. Alright, well, yeah, yellow should be kinda screwed. Oh, where are you all headed, boys? Where are you all headed? Yeah, they'll lead the houses. Oh, take this tower too, take this tower too, man. Wow, what are we waiting on? Get that one too.
DST, DST.
Frost Balamon!
DST,
Frost Balamon!
Oh, he's going for full. Camels there, huh? Going fully for camels, committing to those guys.
DST.
I could capture his stables too, that would be great. Okay, take this tower. Just delete this one, I don't really want it. Keeps my units kinda idle, you know, it keeps my unit idle, I don't like that. Go into his economy. If I had a more mobile unit. And look, he was just chasing that woman there, they lost sight, so they stopped chasing. At least that's more decent. Look, they've got like 10 archers, they need so many volleys to kill that one pikeman.
DST?
Oh yeah, light blue went over to support there. They're popcap, they're fine. Any other metal mine somewhere over here I can try and steal? One there. Would be good to do. Actually, I really should have got the mining upgrades, eh? I really should have got those. Got so much food, I don't know what to use it on, man. I know, actually I do know what to use it on, just buy metal with it, buy metal. And get some more traders out. Yeah, yellow is dead. Maybe we don't need to keep capturing this anymore. And yeah, he's out, we can keep pushing dark blue, light blue. Yeah, he resigns, GG. Yeah, it was a bad strategy by me to try and do like champions without really any extra metal mines. And I didn't really set up any trade early enough. I was really late on that as well. That was a mistake. Oh well, but still. That was quite nice. I want to really see the kill death ratio of me and of Orange, because like Orange should have very few deaths and I should have like the majority of all the deaths, because I'm the meat shield, you know, I am the meat shield. And he is just behind me, kind of supporting, though he was attacking from a different angle, right, so he would still be fighting directly against my opponent there. So we'll see how it looks. I just need to somehow select all the soldiers and push them forward, yeah? And the issue with Pikemen is they are kinda slow. They are kinda slow. And these are normal spearmen, they don't have nearly as much armor. 6 spears, while my pikemen have, normal pikemen have 12 spears. The champion pikes, I think they have 12 spears too. I think they're the same in that regard. Where is one? Where is one of them? Let's check. Yeah, they, oh no, they have 15 spears, they have 15, okay. Okay, okay, I see, I see. So yeah, they deflect 80% of all damage, pierce damage, and have 200 hit points. These guys do 9 damage per hit. So yeah, like they do like 1 point, like kind of 6, 8, something like that per hit here. If they actually do hit and don't miss. So they need over 100 arrows to kill a soldier, to kill one pikeman here. That's kinda... That's a few, you know, that is a few. That is a few. And if you count in like the missing shots, like you need like 2 to 3 full volleys from 100 archers to take out one pikeman, one champion pikeman. That's kinda crazy, you know? And if I've got a hero to support, well, then it's even more insane. I'm not resigning to see the full stats. Okay, there is the resign. Okay. Well, let's check. Yeah, I was the only one really going for champions here. Military score. Yeah, you can see Orange with 5000 military score. And he only lost 100 units there. Only 100. So he had nearly a 4 to 1 kill death ratio. You know, and I will take credit for that. I will take credit for that. All of the credit for that. Because economy score wise, we were... Yeah, he was quite a bit behind, but that's the thing. He doesn't need a lot of economy because he isn't losing soldiers. So he can have like all of them fighting and, you know, like he doesn't need to replenish them. That's the great thing about this. It's your teammate, like you can just simply outnumber your enemy as well. Your teammate doesn't need to have a big economy to keep support, like kind of training new units. If you look at everyone else, yeah, he gathered nearly the lowest amount of food. Actually, red and blue really struggled on food too. That's interesting. They really struggled on that. Yeah, we were fighting against 3 players there for a while. Was it blue, light blue and yellow? Want to see units trained. So yeah, our boom was the strongest, we had a very strong economy. Okay, total score, economy score, that's military. Yeah, economy score wise, you were far ahead, yep. So that's also quite helpful, but the mistake I made here. I only did 2 barracks, I should have done 3 barracks right away and just simply done many more pikemen. Or not really slingers, pikemen, whatever, just simply gone up to phase 2 quite a bit later. So that I have a stronger economy when I'm going for champions and I can afford them earlier. Because for me it still took a while in phase 3 to actually, you know, get them going. Which wasn't great. I want to check the lost. No, not captured, but lost. So there are only a few points in time where he loses units, right? And like when he isn't fighting directly behind me. Can he like get... Units also killed on the other side. Ah, it's hard to tell. Yeah, you can see he was fighting non-stop. But you can also see that at many points, he was not losing many soldiers. And like, he lost the majority of them at one point in time where I stopped fighting or I had gone elsewhere and he was like... Oh, I think that was when I had gone kind of towards the right and he was still pushing yellow and that's where he lost most of the soldiers. Okay. I see, so I wasn't really being the meat shield for him anymore in that location. That was the problem. That's why he lost so many dudes in the end. Okay, I see, I see. Market, trade, gain, trade, income. Ah, not even 2000 metal could have been bare. Could have been bare. Do we have the units alive stat? Not yet, at least, not yet. You can compare like trained and lost, and yeah, he was losing more units than he was training, I guess, I'd say here. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, leave a like, leave a comment. And also, don't be afraid to subscribe if you are new. And I'll see you all later. Peace.